All right, let's wrap up this grid here. You can see up front, Kevin Hansen, Travis Pastrana, Tim Hansen behind his brother, Liam Dorn. In the third row, Kevin Erickson, who absolutely sent it, Andrew Carlson. He broke two wheels yesterday, but very familiar with this track. And finally, Tanner Faust and Oliver Bennett. That is a stacked grid. And remember, this is only heat one.
Cannot wait for this. So 10 seconds to go. Kevin Erickson on row three and Liam Doran on row two are known for round the outside moves. Check them out up at turn two. Tanner Faust is a long way back on the grid. We wouldn't expect him to be there. It's Kevin Hansen on the front row with a good start. And, Travis Pastrana's run wide and Lil B's gone for the sideways line. Timmy Hansen trying to look up the inside. Doran trotting around the outside. Contact between those two. Doran gets sideways. Pastrana's got past Kevin Hansen on the run to turn one. He's made the McSubaru work sideways. And this time, he keeps the door shut. But Kevin trying to get alongside. Doran goes out wide up high. Him and Kevin Erickson. Bennett's gone around the background. Pastrana leads.
Oh my gosh, Andrew, your face is turning red. So excited, so pumped. But look at Liam Doran, Ollie Bennett, then Carlson. He gets into it. So look at this. High and low. Two trailer park girls go around the outside. Talking about Travis Pastrana and Hansen. The high line for him.
Timmy went low there. Kevin went high and Timmy nearly got past. But Kevin had the inside line as they headed over the crest. And he now is in P2 as they go up the top. Now watch here. Who's going to go Joker on this first lap? Is anybody going to dare to slip off? All right, Doran's gone from P4. So Liam Doran goes from P4 in the background into the Yokohama Joker lap. Great
absolutely,
first lap.
Absolutely perfect move for Doran to do that. Now he's going to try to gain some ground, try to bite off more than he can chew. But Pastrana getting the clean air, but he's got both Hansons in his rearview mirror. This is the strategy that the Subaru boys played yesterday. If Scott Speed, who's in P2, they might lock up the front row if they get the victory.
Mistake there in turn two for Kevin Hansen. Just over-rotating the car a little bit. Jared put a wheel up on the grass, and that's meant that Timmy is really closely behind. I wonder if they're going to split their lines down the bottom here. Timmy Hansen goes low again, so wait for the background.
Look at Kevin. Kevin's low. Got interesting high strategy here.
Timmy's going to get him, I think. Kevin looks like he's struggling a little bit with rear traction, but again, he's got the inside line, Jared, and you'll see here he holds on to the position. Timmy going to try and get past him on the other side.
Who moves on? Who moves on? What's at stake here?
Top two go through, and I wonder if Timmy might go Joker and split the strategy. He does.
There
so the
go.
Top two are going to go through. Timmy thinks he's got more pace than his brother, Jared. The worst person to try and pass on track is your teammate. You can't do anything naughty.
Yeah,
you know,
exactly.
So you can't give him the tap, tappity tap on coming through.
No, I mean stepbrothers, right? Did we just become best friends?
We did.
So as Travis Pastrana, look at him. His race line is absolutely fantastic. I tell you, that booter over there is fast and furious. So Kevin Erickson now sits in third, but he needs to bump up a spot. Erickson looking clean, but I'll tell you what, TP, look at 3.4 seconds. We talked about the Joker, how much, how fast is it, which line is the fastest? High, low, and of course, that Yokohama tire Joker line.
Yeah, Pastrana went so well in turn one. We saw Doran make the round the outside in turn one yesterday work. With the track being a bit wider and a bit more grip now, he's going to hold onto the outside line and it put him on the inside. And he just got to turn two ahead of Kevin Hansen. Timmy Hansen now, look, has got a gap of 2.1, maybe 2.7 now, actually, to Erickson in front. Is Erickson going to go Joker? He does. So in the background, Kevin Erickson's in the Joker lap now. Watch for the merge on the outside. Oh, sideways, Timmy Hansen. Tried to shut the door, but Kevin was there first.
Keep in mind, that's a battle for third, right? So you got Erickson and Timmy Hansen, but the real battle, Pastrana and Kevin Hansen. But Pastrana's got a 3.8 second gap. They both need to take a Joker lap. Guess what? As long as Pastrana keeps it clean, says smart, hopefully his spotter's in his ear saying, stay calm, you got this. You're gonna be in the final. It's gonna be nice and easy for the 199.
Pastrana's golden here, really out front. He's all good, but he's behind him on Kevin Erickson. I say he's got Timmy Hansen. Timmy Hansen dropped another second, so I wonder if it's not quite dialed for him at the minute. Kevin Hansen, is he in danger of being caught by Kevin Erickson?
It's about 3.7 seconds, the split there from Kevin Hansen to Kevin Erickson.
Should be enough, shouldn't it?
It's coming down to this. Here we go. Travis Pastrana takes that Yokohama Tire Joker lap for the checker flag, flirting with the dirt in there. But look at Kevin Hansen. Can Erickson catch him? No, not enough time.
Oh, he's going quickly. Can't slide it out wide. Kevin's going to go through with Travis. P1, P2 from the front row.
What a great race. That was a great way to start ERX. Beautiful day, absolute bluebird day. And number 199, Travis Pastrana gets the victory, which ensures him into that 10-car final. Two cars advance on. Kevin Hansen, clean race. It was good. Pastrana's all smiles.
Puts him on the front row as well, doesn't
it? And this Subaru strategy, which we talked about yesterday in the final, we saw Hansen and Scott Speed. Here was the start. Now keep in mind, that's the only paved section of the track. Then they leave it. The rest, all dirt, and it's uphill. So it's a very interesting start. We talk about how critical a start is. What are your thoughts?
He jumped long and almost into the wall on the outside. If you watched Pastrana's line, look at him back the Subaru in. I think maybe with a little bit of nudge from the rear from Kevin. Let who knows there. Doran, look, has gone high and wide. Bennett span in the background. And unfortunately, that cost Carlson. He had nowhere to go and he was stuck. Here we go in the background. Look, Andrew Carlson turns Bennett around a bit further. Nothing to do. Tanner Faust did pretty well there. Where did Tanner end up? At one point, he made it up to fifth. So that's not bad from the back row. And that will see him further up the grid now in the semi-final. But yeah, disaster for Bennett and Carlson. They get to go again. They got the semi-final. They got the O'Reilly's Auto Parts last chance qualifier as well. So it's not over for the drivers who haven't made it, but it's a big advantage for Pastrana and Kevin Hansen right out front.
You talk about Carlson. Talk about advantages. Pastrana, Carlson, Tanner, they've all got an advantage because they've been racing side-by-sides out here this weekend as well. So they're getting used to the track. But who has the most advantage? Andrew Carlson. Yeah, he's doing supercars for the first time, but he built this track. He's very familiar with the track. Yeah, I
it
saw you get
close,
a little nervous. I saw
it?
You get nervous with Joker lap.
The dirt flew up, and I wouldn't say he got lucky. Look in the background. How was Timmy's? It was Kevin, wasn't it, in the background?
Yep.
Not so bad either, but they're really flirting with the wall there. Okay, yeah. So this is up at turn one. Look out front, and Bennett at the bottom of your picture. You can see Travis getting slightly. Look at the guys, all on the bar. So that's Kevin Erickson, Liam Doran. Look, Doran's backwards in the turn. But look at the exit he gets here. Sneaks up the inside. Doink. Ah, it's contact there.
Doran hit Bennett, causing Bennett to spin out. And Doran knows that car. He's familiar with that car. He built the car.
Yeah, he did. He had a lot to do with the engineering on that. So, yeah, a bit of British contact there, Brit into Brit. So have a closer look at the Joker. This is Pastrana. Look, comes in pretty hot, rides the dirt early, but you see the gaps in the dirt, Jared, late. You've got to be a bit careful not to smash a rim on the wall there.
And the photographer heads up with the orange vest there.
Yeah, shout out for the dusting off the lens.
Hopefully he's got some pit vipers on blocking his eyes.
Yeah,
wow,
great race.
Yeah. What a great heat. And again, everybody wins here.
So it's Pastrana and Kevin Hansen who go straight through to the final. Kevin Erickson and Timmy Hansen will have a better starting position when they get through to the semi-finals, as will Faust. Carlson and Bennett had their own issues there. And Liam Doran as well. Looks like Liam disappeared, had an issue too. So a number of people will be looking for a bit of redemption come the semi-finals. But Pastrana and Kevin Hansen go straight through. Travis will be on the front row. It's going to depend what happens with his teammate Scott Speed.
Here is our Heats Race 2 grid. Scott Speed on the front end. Steve Arpin right next to him. He is one to watch. Yeah, he watered his car. He might have lost his front right suspension. He's back stronger than ever. Second row, Robin Larson and Fraser McConnell from Jamaica. Then in third row, Oliver Harrington, Andreas Backer, bringing up the rear. You got Kevin Bigham.
See who gets the best start this time. Arpin's got a banger of a start. The Hyundai going to try and squeeze Speed on the inside. Speed pushes him out wide though. Backward up alongside Larson. Gets in his door. Backward right up into P2, immediately up and over the crest. Arpin's got the inside line on Larson now. Watch from McConnell here in the Jamaican car. He made a brilliant pass up the inside. This time though, things better off. I think it's going to be a Subaru 1-2 on the exit. Arpin with a little nudge on Larson. Larson drops into four. Arpin goes alternate line and in there as well. I think it's Kevin Bigham's gone outside. Chris McConnell's gone inside.
You know, everybody was keeping it really clean until they got to that outside inside. But look at Subaru's high and low. Where are they going to land? Also, we caught up to Katie. What's the update with our racer, Steve Arpin? All right, so it looks like the Subarus keep on. Scott Speed out front, Andreas Backerud. And like I said, Steve Arpin definitely one to watch.
So a Larson, I thought, might go Joker there. He's alongside Arpin here, into the door of Steve Arpin, holding on, little nudge on the rear quarter, getting in a jump long. Look at Arpin, that huge jump yesterday. It's Speed from Backerud. Subaru could see three cars straight through to the final here in the heat race stages, which would be an amazing result for them. Backerud came up a bit short on that jump, hopefully no issues for him. Scott Speed, look, he's what a great driver. Okay, we're going to hear from Katie on Arpin. Katie, what you got?
Yeah, you guys had mentioned that he wadded it up yesterday. He said, we know we have the speed. Today, in order not to do that, I have to take a deep breath, calm down, and link the corners together because this track is all about rhythm. We're definitely seeing that with these drivers here today.
Right now, he's got to watch out for Robin Larson because Larson for the RX cartel is in a big fight here with Arpin. He's been alongside him a couple of times. I would expect to see Larson go joker this time. I think he's got enough air behind him to hold off Fraser McConnell. So watch for McConnell in the background. And he has gone joker. Larson's gone in the joker from the commentary position. We can see that. He's got to come out in front of McConnell. There it is. Bang on the money. Great work from the spotters, Jared.
Speed and back room, absolutely. And again, they listen. They listen to you. Sometimes they don't always listen to you, but they did a great job there. But how amazing. Did you expect the Subarus to be so dominant? We just saw TP do well, but the Hansons even called it. Timmy said, you know what? The Subarus, they're one to watch.
You know what? They might be 10 grand lighter this morning thanks to that fine for unsportsmanlike behavior, but they're handing it to them in a very This is a professional sports team. They're getting out there. That, you know, they're absolutely killing it
and
right
they're,
now.
They're getting proper data right now in regards to the finals. Because look, you're seeing speed go high. You're seeing Baccarat go low. You know, and you're changing it up.
Jared, they can do it. They've got 4.3 seconds. They're doing what they want here. The spotter's going. Can you try the left line for us, see if it's quick? They may split the strategy here for safety. No, so they're even going to fall into the line. So they know now they're going to get a front row lockout with speed and Pastrana. It will put speed on pole, and Baccarat would be on row two. So, you know, perfect for them. And when you look, you want a rear gunner, Jared. You want somebody you can trust behind you not to set you out up at turn two. So it's great for them.
And that's going to be strategy once again. Look at how the Subarus come in here. You know, they've had track time prior to the event. They came out here, got it all tight and bright. So I think all of this just contributes to their success. So you take that outside line. Where are they going to land here? High or low? This is the white flag. Patrick waved it. Where are they going to go? Both of them going high.
Larson's just pulled off the course up at the top hairpin. We could just see out the corner window. I notice he dropped down the timing screens. It's kind of about the battle here between Arpin and McConnell. It's not actually going to make any difference because the two Subarus are going to go through out front, but Arpin and McConnell might just swap places. So watch the Subarus now. They're going to go in line astern. And then if we hang on, we'll see Arpin going into the joker and see where McConnell gets. These guys, though, they're going to go straight to the final. 1-2 for Subaru. Brilliant tactics. Fraser McConnell. That's going to see Fraz on the front row in the semifinal. That's important, too, Jared.
Yeah, so like you said, if you don't get the top two, you go on to the semifinals. Then we have LCQ because only 10 vehicles will be in the final. So five of those folks will be cracking a beverage from the side. But look at this. Here's Robin Larson. Looks like that back left. He's hop, skipping a jump. He is hobbling his way back to the pits.
He has a lot of damage on that rear left corner. He's struggling to even get it back into the paddock. The guys are down there. We're following a drone into the paddock, which is just awesome straight away. But Scott Speed takes it. 1-2 for Subaru in this, and all three cars straight to the final. I tell you what, they're going to be kicking back at the Subaru tent for the next couple of hours.
Sheesh. I saw a spot over here, the Ecktail guys. He's saying, you know, $10,000, I guess we'll pay it, goes towards a good cause, but the good cause is they are 1, 2, and 3. That's insane.
They're not going to mind the 10 grand, are they, if they get their... Imagine a podium lockout, Jared. Imagine a podium lockout. That's what they want. They want to get that blue and yellow. That was Larson, look up at turn two. Steve Arpin went on the inside line, and Arpin and Larson did battle then for the next couple of laps, really. Larson got alongside. He went joker, and look at this. Ooh. We didn't see this, did we? That's great.
Did not. Yeah, the Subaru is absolutely pounding their chests and showing that they are here to win. Like we talk about the Hansons, Subaru's dominant as Travis Pastrana joins us in here. We'll get him on camera. But what a play. I had no idea the Subarus were just going to absolutely be that dominant. But Scott Speed and the strategy, $10,000. Let's get cozy here as this is our monitor as we're getting him in here. But overall, two amazing heats, Coley. We bring in Travis Pastrana. Travis, congratulations, man. And look at Subaru, 1, 2, 3.
Man, I'm so excited. I was kind of looking for Baccarat to take the joker the lap before. That I really think the way Speed took that last one, he could have made a pass. But I tell you, this has been awesome. This is a more wide open track. The Subaru is a bigger car, and I am so pumped. Scott Speed has our starts dialed in. Really controversial yesterday, but Scott is here to win. And he definitely did not want to be in the qualifier with three of the other fastest. He's like, man, let's get on that front row.
Anybody who read the rules was going to go, look, we're going to do a sneaky one. Okay, you got a snap on the wrist. It's not
honestly,
the end of the world,
is it? My jaw dropped. Like, I'm here for the show, too. Like, I'm like, man, we can just go out and have fun. He's like, yeah, it's more fun to win. Like,
you guys get to chill out now for a couple of hours. And you were great up in turn two, Travis. Everyone was right in behind you, and you didn't run wide at all.
I was listening to you yesterday. I'm like, all right. Yeah, like Scott Speed told me, he goes, look, you're used to scrapping. You're used to going to these guys' world. He's like, we have a good car. Yep. He's like, you bring him in the jumps, we have a chance that you don't have to scrap. He goes, when you're in the lead, you set the pace. You set the tone. You got to make them come around you. And it's, I tell you what, I could not be more excited for the series. The crowd, you guys are awesome. Yeah. Thank you so much for coming out. And it's only going to get better from here, guys.
The Hansons are nervous. I feel like Timmy and Kevin are kind of nervous about you. I mean, they talked to Katie, and they're kind of like, Travis is kind of the guy to beat, and the Supers are just looking good. And
now I know you're lying to me. But
come on. I told everybody that you just hate Sweden and the Swedes so much. You don't shop at IKEA. You don't drive a Volvo ever. It's really just, it's aggressive, Travis. Come on.
The Hansons have won every single race that I've promoted and put on. And, I want the best in the world. I want everyone to come over here. I want there to be 100 supercar field deep, just being awesome. And, every track's going to be unique. And I want, there's some wider tracks that the bigger cars are going to do better on, and some of the tight, narrow stuff. I want concrete. I want pavement. I want dirt. I want everything. And, this is a great testament on how different two tracks can be.
I want to know what's going to happen later on today, because we've got three Subarus on the front row. So you do have kind of a problem now in the Hansen. It might be Scott and Backer that you've got to watch out for. What's the team chat going to be later?
There's no... Patrick Sandell, when he's on the team, he's always like, okay, you go in, I go out. Scott goes, look, it's a race. He goes, I'm out here to win. I'm going to do the best that I can to position our team. He goes, I feel like our team's not just going to send each other, but it's not going to be as nice as what Backeroo just did there. He came from like the third row.
I was just looking at the grid.
Unbelievable.
I wonder if we can take a look back at the start again. If we can, if someone can find us a start. Because we didn't see how Backeroo got there. He just got from
the third row. Yeah, he was third row.
Straight up into that position, literally through turn one. It was an epic start for him. I mean, if we can find it, we'll bring it up. There's a bit of battle damage on the back there for Hansen.
The hard part is the first turn, really trying to... Like every driver's meeting, I'm like, look, we got to get the first turn clean. But this, you can go four wide in the first turn. It's awesome. And the outside, you can skip the jump. So you can go, but if you skip the jump, there's a good chance I almost went off and hit the rail. So it's a super dangerous line, but you can make 2/10 if you just get pushed there.
I mean, you got outside line, high, low. There's so many different tracks here. The layout, and like you said yesterday, the track's getting wider. It's drying out.
Oh, here's the start. Look at this. Outside, that's pretty clean.
That's clean.
There.
Look at that. Oh, okay. Gunnar Larson.
Gunnar Larson.
But I mean, it shut the door, didn't you, on Hansen on the inside, and then snuck up the inside of McConnell and Larson. So, brilliant start by Backward.
Hey, look at this. I talk about how many snacks Street Bike Tommy's
been
having.
Tommy.
And of course, show him what you're cooking here. Look at this. Street Bike Tommy in the building. He's giving us some pizza. Dude, you're supposed to be working.
I get a lunch break.
Okay, I guess you can eat.
What about
you,
us?
Of course, yeah.
Every time I'm in the kitchen, you in the kitchen.
All right. We're going to have some pizza. We'll be right back here. Nitro Rallycross, Travis Pastrana, Coley, Street Bike Tommy. Go get me some snack. Make yourself useful. We come back. Nitro Rallycross continues. And here's our semifinal starting grid up front. Kevin Erickson and Steve Arpin. Second row, Tanner Faust and Kevin Bingham. And bring up the rear, Oliver Bennett. Steve Arpin talked about taking a breath. That's what he needs to tell himself. But I'll tell you what, we got two of the sendiest boys here, Arpin and Tanner Faust, on turn one. It has this little booter that absolutely sent them to the moon. So what do we got, Colin?
Arpin's outside. He needs a good start. He can hold on around the outside. He'll be inside for turn two. It's a great start for Kevin Erickson. Maybe a better start from Arpin. Arpin can't squeeze it, though. Kevin's on that wall side. Pastrana and his teammate, Kevin Bingham, side by side in a contact. Bennett will look to capitalize on that. Arpin's gone for the inside line. Kevin's seen him, going to try and do it. Arpin makes the move Pastrana made earlier on. He's late on the brakes and gets that machine in around the outside. Tanner Faust has gone for P2 and he pulls it off. Faust locked in P2. Brilliant drive.
Great execution by Tanner Faust. Says, you guys go ahead and fight. I'm going to go around outside and get that clean line. But I'll tell you what, like you said, drivable Steve Arpin. So Arpin out front, Tanner Faust. Everybody taking the high line except Oliver Bennett in the next side mini.
Look at the difference between Arpin and Faust there. Arpin at the car rotating sideways early. Faust waits a little bit longer. Bennett's gone past Bingham for the looks of things. Ollie Bennett up into P4. He texts me in between the races there. I didn't even spin in turn one. Liam took me out. So, okay, fair go.
All right.
I thought he was going to go joking, but he doesn't this time.
I would have got it. I mean, again, they do not listen to you, but we are, again, bringing up that of Ollie Bennett in the back. Steve Arp and the Hemp Fusion low and bro, double zero, the Canadian Cowboy. He's feeling the flow. He goes over that booter once again. That's the one that sent him to the moon and broke off his front right suspension yesterday.
Kevin Erickson's just come past the announcing booth slowly, so I think Kevin looks like a rear left issue to me for Kevin. He's 9.5 down already. Went Joker, but I suspect he's going to pull off back to the paddock, so that's not ideal. Arpin, look at the gap he's got on Faust.
And earlier, Katie Osborne caught up with Tanner Faust. He says, you know, the side-by-side, he got in, he's racing, he's doing double duty here this weekend in his Polaris side-by-side, and obviously in his Rockstar Energy Audi. With him qualifying and getting into the finals, give more time to work on the car, get the Audi more dialed, and make sure that he's up for it.
Is that a spin for Faust?
Oh,
it is,
no.
And just as we say that, Faust has had a spin at the top of the hill. Just saw it in the background of the shot. He's going to go Joker lap now. Remember, the top two go through from this, so this could well have opened the door for either Ollie Bennett or Cameron Bigham to go through, so this would be huge for Bennett if he can get through to the final at this stage. So he's under pressure now from Cameron Bigham. You're seeing the leader Arpin, but the battle is definitely now between Bennett, Bigham, and Faust.
Yeah, that butcher box, the Audi Dry Reinbold vehicle, Cameron Bigham. He's having a little struggles, you know, he's having some, he says, not the best day yesterday, but look at that, Cameron Bigham gets inside of Ollie Bennett.
They need to watch out. Tanner Faust is on the hunt behind. He's made a small mistake. Faust is absolutely settling it in the Audi. He's fully committed now. He's already closed the gap down. It's come down to 1.6. So Tanner Faust here might have undone that mistake in one lap. Needed to respond. And Faust is with them already. Brilliant. Shows the class of the guy. He's one of the best rally cross drivers in the world. Tanner Faust is one of the only guys who've won on both sides of the Atlantic.
This is the moment that Steve Arpin, like he said, he needs to take the breath, be calm, drive smart. Don't overdrive the car. He said very drivable. But look at this. The fight for second is the real one. You got Cameron Bigham, Oliver Bennett, and Tanner Faust fighting for that spot to just solidify in the finals.
Yeah, Tanner's joking. The other guys haven't. So his spotter will be on the radio to him and saying, look, don't worry. You don't need to push here. You can follow the guys home. I don't think Tanner will risk it unless the door is wide open. He might as well just sit and wait here. And the door looks like it is wide open. Up at the hairpin, and he nudges. So another problem. So Tanner hits the back of Bennett. Now it's back on again. This fight is absolutely lit for P2.
Cameron Bigham's like, cool, you guys go ahead and fight it out. I'm going to try to get the second spot because Arpin, he's not even part of the equation. He's in la-la land right now. So a couple more turns here for Steve Arpin, but the fight for second is on. Cameron Bigham goes over the big jump.
Bigham then in the air with the excitement in the background. Now you're seeing the fight. That's what we need to see. Faust is trying to get back. He's already fought his way back after a mistake at the top of the hill. Made another mistake in the hairpin down at the other end. Into the Joker lap goes Bigham and Bennett. Arpin takes the win. Faust slides through sideways. Oh, and it's going to get out of track by his own teammate. Cameron Bigham steals it at the line from Tanner Faust. Two mistakes, unusual for Faust. And he's going to have to go to the last chance qualifier.
Dude, that butcher box Audi just nailed it there. And his Instagram handle, follow the ham. And that's exactly what those dudes did. Talking about Tanner Faust and Ollie Bennett getting that second spot, solidifying him going to the finals. Tell you what, we talked about it. Arpin delivered. Absolutely. The double zero out front, getting all the
7 seconds up the road.
Holy
fair
cow.
Play to Arpin. We barely had to talk about him, Jared, because he just wasn't ever in danger. So this is Arpin off the line. Look, Kevin Erickson, we don't wear this, but do you have any contacts? I mean, nudge the wall maybe on the inside. Watch Arpin now. This was the Pastrana line. Travis said it's risky. He goes, you can risk it. I was super close to the wall, and so was Arpin. But he got it done. I wonder how many of the other drivers are watching that for later on today.
Right. No, I mean, really well done. Tanner Faust, very unlike him. I mean, he was looking good and strong, but him and Ollie get into it. He cut the corner. I mean, he was all over the place. This is not Tanner Faust.
I wonder if there's a problem, because if you think about it, Jared, he had two half spins. This was absolutely brilliant, by the way.
Yeah.
Kevin Erickson's in the back of Arpin, desperately trying to make sure he's got the door shut, and Tanner's gone, don't worry about that, I'll just go all the way around the outside, which is Kevin's classic move. But then Tanner has an unusual half spin. Here it is. So watch Faust now in P2. He's not far off the back. What does he do?
Oh.
Yeah, the car's loose to me. And watch as well, Jared, if we see the Joker merge, it's over-rotating in the corner. So I think maybe a little technical issue for Faust. We might see that from another angle.
Faust and that Rockstar energy drink. There it is. So going up on the berm, like you said, he's trying to throw it in. Is it loose or is it too tight?
Well, he's hooked the dirt on the inside there, which has spun him round. But I don't know if that was because of another issue. It still looks like he's got all-wheel drive to me. But then as he comes around, say, later on, watch this. Watch the merge now, and you'll see what I mean about it. He doesn't seem to have the four-wheel drive. He's too sideways. I think we're going to see it. Yeah, we are. So yep. So watch for Faust. These guys go off. Now watch Tanner's attitude in the Audi as he comes through this corner. It slides a lot to the rear. Does drop it in the dirt, though.
Gets to that dirt.
It's hard to tell. Is it just mistakes? It's uncharacteristic if it is.
Yeah, I mean, that is not Tanner Faust. So crazy turn of events there, but it was all Arpin, that hemp fusion, low and bro, Hyundai delivering. And he's seen him. He is going to be seeing the finals. You know what? Congratulations to Kevin Bigham, too. Like I said,
yeah.
Kind of struggling with that Butcher Box Oink Audi Dry Reinbold vehicle. It's new to him, but it's great because now it just solidifies.
He nearly got collected by his teammate didn't he? That was nearly a bit of teammate on teammate contact. Okay, so we're hearing the cab Bigham is under review. Where would the review be from? Maybe the start, I think. I'm sure we'll see it, but it'll be the run between turn one and turn two, I imagine. So Cabot Bigham under review.
Here is our grid for semifinal race two. Frazier McConnell, Timmy Hansen out in the front. Oliver Erickson and Andrew Carlson. And finally, as you said, Andrew, the RX Cartel, Robin Larson and Liam Doran bringing up the rear.
30-second board goes up. Keep your eyes on the cartel at the back, particularly Liam. Liam, I know, has been backing it in every single lap up at the first corner. He's doing it this morning when the dirt there was super deep. Andrew Carlson, local driver, parents, owner, run the track with him.
And like you said, Carlson, he needs to remind himself this is an off-road truck. But I'll tell you what, our cartel, they might very well blow their way all the way to the front.
Here we go, Frazier McConnell has the inside line. Timmy Hansen on the outside, almost a jump start from Andrew Carlson. He drops backwards off the line on the Erickson, gets inside. Doran up two places already into the side of Carlson. Timmy Hansen around the outside of Frazier McConnell. Erickson drops in, so Spraz now trying to out-track Timmy. Get a squeeze on the brakes. Frazier shuts the door. Timmy looks to make the move that he couldn't make earlier. Doran goes in super sideways, trying to get inside Ollie, and he can't. It's Timmy Hansen who leads from Frazier McConnell, and Ollie Erickson slots into P3.
Frazier McConnell in that second position. Remember, we take the top two. Looks like McConnell and Hansen, one and two. Hansen takes the lead. Erickson there in third. And Doran, like I said, very aggressive driving, almost spins around. Look at Fraz getting loose on that high line.
I think you guys would say Fraz is getting after it, isn't he? You can see there, he's absolutely on the lock stops. Mid-corner there, big send. Ollie Erickson, Doran. Now, watch for Joker strategy here because these four guys are all fast. Is anyone going to duck out and lap one and risk it? They're not. Doran goes. Last second call from Liam Doran. That'll be Dave Mansfield has told him to go. He's got his old English spotter with him. Yeah. Used to spot for Backer and Ken Block. He's a real pro, and he sent Liam in, but it was a last-minute decision, Darren. He might have lost time.
Sketchy. Yeah. That was real sketchy. Yeah. You could almost hit the wall there, but Liam Doran comes out unscathed. Andrew Carlson, he takes his Joker lap as well.
Frazier McConnell having a look at the pass. Look at the gaps for Hansen. He's on the limit today. You can hear it bah, 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 all the way through turn two up there, but he holds on to the position at the moment.
Timmy Hansen out front, making it look proper. Frazier McConnell now. Oh, look at that. Frazier McConnell taking the high line. Timmy Hansen taking the low line. And he gained some ground.
I think the Hansen line's good there. I expect to see some of the drivers swap down to that line on the next one. Hansen sweeps in from out wide. All three out front. What's the gap back to Doran at 5.2? I think Liam lost time on the way into the Joker, so you could go this lap now and protect yourself from that attack. Do they go for P3? No, they've all got the standard lap. And Larson goes through as well on the standard lap behind these guys.
I'll tell you what, Ollie Erickson, he's one to watch right now because he is looking at Frazier McConnell. He's got him up front. He can get that proper line. Timmy Hansen still out front. There's that big Buddha that sent Steve Arpin crashing his car as he stands next to me.
McConnell or Erickson has got to go Joker on this lap. They want to split the strategy up. Erickson looks to the inside line. McConnell just gets away with again that all-wheel drive, putting the car straight. Look how close Erickson was to the wall. Every 10th counts now, Jared. One of those two has got to go. Their teammates, remember, so the spotters up top have been discussing what the strategy is between the two cars.
That's right. So Frazier McConnell still going for that high line. Timmy Hansen taking the unpopular low line. Everybody taking the high line. And look at Ollie Erickson. He wants to get up there past the Jamaican driver that is Fraz.
So I reckon they'll send Ollie if Fraz doesn't go, I think. Ollie's going to go Joker surely in the background. He does. So Ollie Erickson goes into the Joker. Frazier stays out. His lap now's got to be perfect. He wants to try and get the overlap on Fraz and book a spot in the final.
Doran does move up to third place. He gets around that of Ollie Erickson. Oh, excuse me, Larson. Thank you so much. Great to be there.
No worries, mate. The Monster Energy RX Cartel boys, they're pretty similar out there. They're certainly both super sideways, aren't they? Timmy Hansen with Frazier McConnell right with him. Frazier now will know he's being hunted. They'll be on the radio going, this lap, give it everything you've got.
Timmy Hansen getting really loose. I love that section. Again, looks like a stage rally. Fraz is going to try to get past him, taking that high line once again. Is he going to catch him? What do you think, Cole?
I think Hansen and McConnell have both got a joker here. Larson just in front is going to lose out to Ericsson. So the danger here is Ericsson to McConnell. There's 2.2 seconds in it at the moment. I reckon McConnell might just about have enough, but Ollie's looking for that perfect lap. Where is Braz? He's gone in the joker now. This is it then. Timmy Hansen, Fraser McConnell coming out. Watch for Ollie Ericsson in the background. Ericsson tries to shut the door, but Hansen and McConnell go through.
Nice, well played, Timmy Hansen. Braz McConnell, 1 and 2.
Larson's rear wing's gone, Jared. You see, we're looking at, if you guys from looking out the window here, we can see the rear wing is off Larson's car. He's actually done pretty well to hold on to that. Ooh, a wild ride.
All right, we'll throw a headset on a gentleman that's already in the finals, and that is Steve Arpin joining us up here. But Timmy Hansen, let's take a look at the replay here. And Steve Arpin, the 00, we'll throw on your headset and get some words with you, making sure. Arpin, congratulations, homeboy.
I'll tell you what, after that heat race, I was getting a little bit nervous, but the car was really good. We tried a little setup thing, and it wasn't quite what we wanted. The boys put it back to where we had it before and tweaked on it, and we're right back to where we were.
What do you make of the semifinal? I mean, Fraz, very impressive. Timmy Hansen, he joins his brother. Impressive.
I don't think there hasn't been a boring race out here. This track is absolutely incredible. So many elevation changes, so many just, look at that. Like, just dive into the joker. Liam will always send it.
Well, the call was slightly too late, wasn't it, I think, for Liam. It was the right call, I think, to go in. He needed to try something. You know what it's like, Steve, sometimes you've got to try something. And he's gone in, but it was a late call. Oh, look at Ollie. He was wild with the rundown.
Piece of driving to save that.
Larson's rear wing's gone. I'm not sure the team got any of those with it. So where did he drop the wing and did it get run over? They'll be hoping it didn't. They'll want to, we can bolt that back on.
Yeah, we're good.
That works.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, guys, how about Fraser McConnell?
Dude, that's
like, Timmy Hansen is a world champion. He is one of the most decorated rallycross racers on earth, right?
Yeah.
Fraser McConnell is stepping it up. He's going to take names going forward.
Have you had a decent catch up with Fraz? He's a good lad, isn't he?
Well, honestly, so we did a deal at the end of the ARX season years ago where the lights champion got a test in my car. And
yes,
that was Fraz.
It was.
And I rode around with him for one lap and I just got out. It's like, he's going too fast for me. I don't want to be a part. I don't want to be a passenger in this deal. So the kid's just a natural talent.
Oh man, guess what? Actually, Race Control is looking at lap one, turn two. So let's take a look.
This is it now, yeah. So Timmy's kind of inside Fraz. So did Timmy give Fraz a push? Even if he did, it's in the background. Liam's in sideways. Liam got into Ollie, did he? No, not really.
I can't see a penalty being there. And just really what they're doing right now is they're trying to get the track prep, sacrificing a little bit of grip right now. Sacrificing a little bit right now, but we're going to have a really good track. So it's a little bit slippery going into that corner for sure.
All right, well, we have the Hemp Fusion
Low and Bro.
Act now. Go to Hemp Fusion. Put in code ARPIN for 25% off. It's a one-time only deal. Mike, did I get that right?
With free shipping.
Love that. He's hawking some CBD here. But, hey, what a track, man. Absolutely. Yesterday, you broke your front suspension, but are you breathing? I think that's the big priority here.
Hang on. Hold on. He's getting a phone call. Who is it, Steve? See if it's the wife. If it is, you need to take the call.
It's Far Dad from Yokohama.
is this important?
I don't think so.
Okay, no,
so
he goes.
I was calling them. Their little gantry fell down there, so I called them, let them know their gantry fell down.
Oh, see, what a nice dude.
Yeah.
Hey, what a nice dude.
Nitro Rallycross, just everything here. You know, from Utah to this track, again, it's absolutely transformed. And from yesterday to today, unbelievable.
Honestly, I can't think of something that I would be more excited to be a part of.
Okay.
It's the most excitement that's been around Rallycross globally ever. What Travis has put together, just the crazy stuff that comes into Travis's head. Like I said last week, they're like, is Travis nuts or is he a genius? It's like, well, he's nuts to think of the stuff he thinks of, but he's a genius to bring it to life, right?
I love it.
And this racetrack is obviously the Carlsons and ERX, the amazing facility, but to adapt it to these cars, these Rallycross cars, and to send them through the air the way we are. I went a little bit too far yesterday, but we'll back that up a little bit.
Just a scotch.
Right?
You went a suspension too far because you broke your front right quarter. There's how the bracket is laying out. Arpin is up in the mix. Look at that. There you see Travis Pastrana, Scott Speed there up front. Andreas Backer, Kevin Hansen. This gentleman right here, Steve Arpin, Timmy Hansen, Tanner Faust, Fraz McConnell. He is up in the mix. When we come back, we'll find out who's going to join him here. Round two of Nitro Rallycross ERX. Steve Arpin, Andrew Cole, and Jared Deanna. When we come back, Nitro Rallycross continues. I'm looking forward to Arizona, Travis said two over-unders in Arizona, wow, going off course, coming back in. And then, you know, Glen Helen, iconic track. It's going to be really dusty, really tight, really small. And then the firm is TBD. We'll see.
I'm still hoping we might see you for more, Timmy. I know at the minute you're only doing the first two, but, I mean, you kind of are leading the championship, which makes things a little bit tricky, doesn't it?
We'll see. if I win today, we'll see. No.
All right, who's to watch here in the LCQ? I mean, we're only taking two, but Ollie Erickson there on the front row. We got, you know, the RX Cartel. We're only taking two, so there's five vehicles they're going to be watching from the side.
Yeah, and loads of these guys have been super fast. I think both Ollie and Kevin Erickson has more pace, really, than should have needed to be in the LCQ. But yeah, this is going to be another tough race. Like, every single battle yesterday was super tough,
right,
and including this race, you have to treat it like it's a final, and you have to go all in.
The field is stacked, isn't it? I was trying to compare it to previous seasons of championships we've done, and I think it's really hard to win here.
Absolutely, yeah. Ollie that we see now, he's a killer in the first two turns, but I know there will be some guys on the back that's looking for outside moves and stuff.
All right, real quick before we go to the race, Katie, what's up?
Well, you guys are talking about someone to watch, and Liam Doran said actually he was really happy with how he is feeling with the car. The car is extremely reliable, but throughout the weekend it was him who had made a mistake. Now, one thing he also said is in this race it comes down to who wants to race. This weekend the track is good, there's clear visibility. The driver doesn't have a whole ton of excuses, so really it's the person who wants it more. Timmy, as you've been out there racing, how much would you say that's true, especially as you guys have kind of use the term maximum attack?
Yeah, that's definitely what you have to do. So these guys will be all pumped up and full of adrenaline right now.
You think? Looks like you're getting suited up, ready to race. Oliver Erickson on the front row next to Oliver Bennett, Robin Larson, Cabot Bigham, Liam Doran, Kevin Erickson, and bring up the rear, Andrew Carlson, who's very familiar with the track, but he wants to produce three laps, got to take the Joker, and only two are going to our supercar finals.
Okay, then here we go. The deep growl. Seven cars, two spots available. Ollie Bennett normally gets a great start. He's got to get a good one to get in front of Ollie Erickson. Better start from Larson on row two. Larson trying to find the inside line. Cabot Bigham going around the outside. Ollie Bennett going to go defensive, surely on the run to the far end now. Bennett's got a good lead here. Huge jumps. Oh! Kevin Erickson has just gone super big on the jump. Larson still no rear wing on his car. Erickson looks up the inside line. It's Ollie Erickson who leads. Liam Doran gets into the side of Kevin Erickson. Has to go to the option line. I think the Audi's broken. Doran's up. Wild.
Wow. Liam Doran comes in hard. That was a huge send there by Erickson. He saw absolutely air it out. Oh, and Erickson flips to the far side. Wow. Erickson rolls over. He finds out. He looks like a rubber meets the road. Absolutely insane. Woo. Erickson out front.
Wild. So spin for Liam. Contact him. Maybe Larson just sideways because the rear wing's missing from that car. Cab a bigger bit behind him. Let's reset and take a look and see where everyone is. So right now, Ollie Erickson out front. Ollie Bennett goes Joker on lap one. That's not a bad decision. Going to stick himself back out into P3. Larson missing the rear wing. And is it Carlson who's up into P4? It is.
That is right. Andrew Carlson jumping up there. So we see Ollie Bennett now sitting third. And he did hit that Joker lap. So Ollie Erickson out front. And then Larson sitting second.
Timmy, how on earth did they all end up jumping so far? Is that where the track's been prepped? It was like the entire field launched it big time.
Everyone knows that run down to turn two is super important. Like, Ollie made a crazy good turn one to get out in front, but then Ollie was like a big risk, big reward kind of move there on the jump, and he went further, and now he's in the lead, and looks to me like he has control here.
Ollie Bennett chasing down Robin Larson. Bennett is the leading driver. He's joked at 5.3. He's only 1.4 back to Larson. He's got to hang on to him, and Larson's missing his rear wing, Jared.
Oh, man, I'm really surprised. I mean, Kevin Erickson looks like he pulls off. Doran pulls off as well. So Erickson, Doran, DNF, Erickson, Larson, Bennett. And like you said, Bennett has hit that Joker lap.
Timmy, talk to me about Larson's car. The rotation on it looks insane to me. That's where the rear wing's missing, I'm guessing. Erickson's got Joker and come out in the lead. Brilliant move by him. But is Larson's car hard to drive? In some ways, it looks to me pretty good on the turn in.
Oh! Kevin Bennett overhand.
In turn one, Bigham has destroyed the car. Absolutely destroyed the car.
Let's make sure he's okay. That's going to be... That was a big wreck there.
He's okay.
So do I. Okay, back to the front of the race. Ollie Erickson, they're on their final lap, so they may not red flag this. They might finish it. Just get the drivers to stop close to the line. Bigham's moving in the car. He's moving in the car. We'll get him checked out. Ollie Erickson leads from Robin Larson. Bennett, 3.2 is just, he's within reach of Larson.
This is on for second place between Bennett and Larson. So if Larson is the joker lap now, he can come in second place.
Okay, here we go. Larson going off to the joker lap. This is for a place in the final. Ericsson definitely going through, but watch where is the merge for Ollie Bennett. Bennett going to try and race it to the line, but Larson's got it done. Great drive. Robin Larson books the last slot in the final. Ollie Ericsson is in there as well. And as you can see, Cabot Bingham is out. I think he's out. Is he out of the car? Or is that the rescue crews down there? Hard to tell.
He is moving. Absolutely sensational crash. Just want to make sure he's okay. As racing did continue, that was the last lap. As Ollie Ericsson and Larson, there he's out. Cabot Bingham is out.
Big hand from the crowd here at ERX Motor Park for Cabot Bingham. That was an absolutely huge crash. And we never want to see that. We really don't. And now we know he's okay. Maybe we'll take another look. He's looking good to me, Timmy. He looks all right. I know they'll take you. They normally take you off for a checkup after a big shunt like that, but he looks okay.
Yeah, but he will be shocked right now that he's just come out of a crash like that. I hope they take him to the hospital right now. It can take a little while before you start to feel the pain.
Adrenaline, yeah.
But I'm happy to see he's on his feet and he seems to be okay right now.
Wow, I want to roll that back. You saw him just air it out over that first turn. You know, start finish. It looked like it nosed down and then it buffed him up.
So this is the start, in fact. This is the run to turn two. So Bennett in the lead at this point in the background. Watch for Kevin Ericsson coming in the R53 back car. Larson goes outside. Kevin Ericsson goes inside. Tiny bit of contact with Bingham. Ollie Bennett did really well there. Doran comes up the inside, and Doran's car's obviously broken. Yeah, front right steering, could see the rods gone. Kevin still sideways. Larson just misses his teammate, still running without a rear wing. And after Bingham's car, there aren't going to be any spare wings, I can tell you that
much. Ericsson flips. Ericsson flips right here, going into the high-low. He chooses the center, because watch, he goes low, and he ends up on his roof, and he eventually does flip over. Watch this.
That just kicked really strange, didn't it? That kicked really weirdly. That's a soft roll, and that car will be okay. There's a bit of work to do, but it's not a biggie.
I want to say good job to Robin Larson here. He came out right at the back,
Cabot.
And he managed to get through.
Yeah.
Oh. I'll tell you what, from Utah to now here at ERX, that car has taken abuse. That car could very well, might even be totaled out, that front end and all the damage.
I think the issue here is that obviously they've only got 4 or 5 weeks, and to me that there is a huge amount of work to do on that. Most of the technicians will be due to fly back to Europe. You know, they'll look for the support of the guys at DRR, Dry and Rainbow Racing as well. But let's hope that isn't a season-ending crash for Cabot Bingham, because there is a lot of damage on that car.
I hit front to back to front to back, and that is expensive.
You look at Ollie's roll, and Ollie's roll is a nothing, isn't it? And you look at Cabot's roll, and it's the total. I think you can see from the carnage on the car. But the most important thing, cars really don't matter. Cabot's okay, and that's the most important thing here.
Yeah, and you know, that was the last lap, so they let him race, and he was beyond that finish line. So that's why they let him go out. Yeah, that was pretty sensational. Glad he's okay. We're going to clean up the track here and continue on. So just to recall it, how did it finish? I mean, I'm kind of fixated on Cabot's crash there, but the two that advanced from the LCQ.
So it was Larson minus his rear wing, who just seems to be able to get the best rotation ever on the car. He may have just redesigned our rallycross cars by going, do we need a rear wing? So he dives off to the right-hand side here, watching the background for Bennett. Bennett just needed a little bit more lap pace, and Larson had got it done. And when it came to the merge, that's Ollie crossing the line, and you'll see Larson pop in for the bottom just there. Bennett was really close. Shout out to Ollie. His pace has been really good here this weekend against the best rallycross drivers in the world. So look at Larson sticking it in the dirt on the outside line.
And it's great to see one of the RX Cartel guys make it in. You know, Liam goes out early in that LCQ. He crashes, and then Robin Larson continues. Like you say, sans that wing. Ollie Bennett, like you said, just a little bit more in the tank. And he hit that joker lap very early.
Larson with a big jump over the line. That's one thing that will affect the car without the rear wing, and it will just affect the trajectory in the air. So this is turn one. So look at the size of the jumps here. Look at this. Look, I mean, that's just insane from Kevin in the background. I wonder if
look
something
at Liam
broke.
Doran right here.
Yeah, go
from
on.
The way back and cuts inside and gets three places.
He was unlucky, wasn't he, really?
Then he has the damage. That's bad luck.
So with Kevin, I wonder if something broke, Timmy, from that jump. Because to me, I think the rear left, look at the angle of the rear left to me, looks like it's gone. And I think he gets caught out and into the roll, but we didn't get to see it
something
from that
happened
angle.
For him on the takeoff before the jump. And then he just flew sideways and no chance to save
it. I think it looked like his line, he was going to fly off that hip and go into those tires. So I think last minute he corrected. So the attitude of the vehicle, it kicked him and then just hit that berm. That's crazy LCQ. LCQ in Utah was like this.
Yeah.
I mean, everybody's kind of just really fighting for your maximum attack. So, man, all right, let's throw it down to Katie. Katie's with Cabot Bingham.
Yeah, we talked right before that LCQ that Cabot Bigham was actually feeling the highs and the lows of racing. And now you literally felt that way. First and foremost, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm doing fine. I want my dad and mom to know that, because that, I don't know if they caught it on video, but that probably looked pretty scary. My spotter came on the radio and was like, hey, I'm all good, thank you. Hey, you guys, you can catch these guys in front, you know, you're in a good spot, you jokered, they didn't. So I kind of gave it a little bit more coming over that turn one crest, and honestly don't know what happened. I think it just kind of hooked the inside tire, and it just caught and started tumbling me, and then I went end over end. So it's a bummer for sure, because I think we could have actually made that final. But I guess the most important thing is that I'm fine. I'm not injured. Now it'll be a miracle to try and get that car back to where it needs to be for racing. So I have faith in these guys. I think they'll be able to do it, but I'm all good.
And that, guys, is the most important thing. Yeah, he's saying these cars needs fixed. Man, round one, same thing. Round two as well. Tough break for Cabot Bigham.
Yeah, he's wearing it, man. I feel for him. The Butcher Box vehicle of Cabot Bigham, Dreyer Reinbold. I feel for him, man. Absolutely gutted. Just a tough year, like you said. But overall, spirits are high.
He's okay. That's the most important thing. Let's check the results.
Yep. So Ollie Erickson and Robin Larson are your one and two, the top two finals. So Ollie Bennett, Andrew Carlson, Cabot Bigham, Kevin Erickson, Liam Doran are watching from the sidelines.
Yeah, a couple of DNFs there with Erickson and Doran, but it was Cabot Bigham with the big one, I'm afraid. Yeah. That was huge. And there's a lot of work for the team to do if we're going to see that car at all again this season.
Here we are. This is ERX, and this is round two of Nitro Rallycross. Yeah, that's right. Hashtag go Nitro, because we are ready for our supercar final. 10 cars, 6 laps, only one can win. And look at that. Subaru, 1, 2, and 3. Man, they are on that front row. I'm Jared Deanna. Joining me once again, Andrew Coley. Super pumped. A beautiful day. But guess what? It's going to get nuts, and we're going to send it here in just a little bit.
One more race to go here at ERX Motor Park. Yeah, you can see the Subaru's done a great job during qualifying, but the Hansons, look, they're both there on row 2 and row 3. None of this is a foregone conclusion. Amazing. Scott Speed, brilliant performance by him. Bit tactical yesterday. Didn't go down super well with everyone, but they got what they wanted, Jared. They read the rules. They wanted to lock the front route. Both him and Travis did the job they needed to do to be on the front.
They won their heats, so here they are, front row. Subaru 1-2, and then right behind them, Andreas Backrud. All eyes are on Travis Pastrana, not only because, yeah, it's Nitro, but he wants to produce. He wants to win. And if you can recall Utah, it was over in turn one, similar to Sage. But just like Sage, never give up. And that's why he's on that front row. And there it is, the trio, Andreas Backrud sitting in that second row.
Yeah, Backrud's on the outside. That's not a bad place to be. And I suspect that he'll stay on the outside to try to hold the inside line and play tail gunner, either for Travis or Scott on the inside there. And that will keep the Hansons on the outside into turn two.
And here's our Nitro Rallycross final grid. On that front row, Scott Speed and Travis Pastrana. Second row, Kevin Hansen, Andreas Backrud. Third row, you got the Canadian Cowboy, Steve Arpin, who got second place in Utah. Can he podium again? Right next to him, Tim Hansen, Frazier McConnell from Jamaica, Tanner Faust next to him. And on that final row, Robin Larson and Oliver Erickson. A couple Swedes bringing up the rear. Well, here we go, Andrew. Call the action. Woo! You ready? Are you ready to send it? Nitro Rallycross.
Here we go then, round two, final time, 10 cars, 6,000 horsepower, there can only be one winner. Is it going to be a Subaru podium lockout? Can the Hansons continue their domination of Nitro Rallycross? Speed with a better start, Pastrana back for a two, back for a shuts the door, and Kevin Hansen immediately tries on the inside line. Kevin going to run it wide. Two Subarus go super sideways. I think it's in Pastrana maybe that's gone backwards. So Backrud tries to do it, but Kevin Hansen has managed to get on the inside line. Can't see it. Hansen, I think, in P2. It is. Kevin Hansen has made it up into second place. It's Scott Speed, though, who leads as they exit the hairpin. Oh,
we got
the wall.
Oh,
Backrud.
Wow.
Backrud hit the wall with the front right of the Subaru.
Oh, my goodness. How did he keep it upright? I mean, that was amazing. I mean, I was surprised that they made it through turn one, to be honest.
Speed on the inside line. Pastrana is in P3 at the minute. Kevin Hansen flies the jump super long in P2. Look at this. You've got Fraser McCall on the right, Ollie Erickson on the left. Just in front of them, he's backwards. Somehow that car's in one piece. He's on the tail of Arpin. Looks up the inside, takes Steve Arpin. Timmy Hansen is up there. Arpin gets pushed wide. Who's going to go Joker? I can't believe nobody
took the Joker. Scott Speed, he's up front. He's got the clean air. One lap down. Can Scott Speed get on the podium and get a Subaru for the first time this year?
Okay. Kevin Hansen's bought the party, Jared. and he's in there in the Peugeot. The Hansons have won every round of Nitro Rallycross so far. Speed will be desperate, but Pastrana coming in hot in the background. Pitches the Subaru round into a big slide. Great performance by them.
They can definitely tag team here on Kevin Hansen. Like you said, Hansen has been on the podium every single Nitro Rallycross round. Look at this. Travis Pastrana taking that inside line.
Pastrana for the low line. Pastrana up the inside of Kevin Hansen. Going to get this done. Scott Speed checking up Kevin Hansen. Pastrana going to get to B2 here. Kevin's got the inside line over the jump. Waiting for the long right hander now. If Pastrana can hold up around the outside, he could be inside for the hairpin at the top of the hill.
Oh,
he's got it done.
Like Pastrana.
Pastrana's got it done.
Gets the pass. Scott Speed, Pastrana 1-2 with Hansen sitting in third. Absolute well done by the 199 to get that number 2 spot.
That was set up, Jared, from so far back when you said he'd gone on the alternate line. He held that alternate line the whole way over the jump to the inside line. Is he going to try and pull a similar move? This is the move he did earlier on his own teammate.
And there are no team orders. Travis told that earlier. All Subaru wants to see is a Subaru on the podium. If it's 1 and 2, if it ended right now, they'd be absolutely elated. And guess what? Travis really wants to beat Hansen. And look at it. Here we go.
Speed's gone on the alternate line this time. In the background, that's Timmy Hansen, who's coming in to join his brother Kevin Hansen backwards in P5 at the minute. Subaru sweeping through high and low on the line. The sun visor's come completely off Pastrana's car. That could hinder him. The sun's pretty low now, but at the minute he's in P2 and he's hoping to chase his teammate. Only Larson and Faust have joked so far.
Yeah, I mean, nobody's taking the Joker. Looks like Andreas Backer, a little smoke coming off his vehicle there as he makes that turn. Looks like shaved a little bit of tires. Still, no Joker. Like, oh,
Timmy in the background. Timmy Hansen goes Joker. That releases Backer. Backer could maybe hold him up for Subaru. That really is about this run three. There's a bigger gap between them after Backer clipped the wall. There's just a bigger gap for these guys.
So Scott Speed still out front, and just behind him, Travis Pastrana, his Subaru teammate. And now Kevin Hansen, looks like he's falling back a little bit.
Pastrana's looking really good here. Speed now goes to the inside line again. This is where Travis got it done. I wonder if Speed's going to stay low. Maybe Scott saw the move from Travis and he's thinking, I'm not opening the door for that. They swap lines. Yes, Speed goes high, Pastrana goes low.
Yep.
Pastrana going to come up alongside Speed. Not quite close enough.
I'll tell you what, Kevin Hansen, he's losing ground, surprisingly. I mean, Hansen, you know, again, talking about Hansen's winning 2018-19. Just last round in Utah, but Scott Speed looking very dominant. And there,
Pastrana.
Pastrana taking that Yokohama Tire Joker lap. He loses position, but he gets it out of the way, and he's got 2 laps left to go.
Hard to see from that angle, Jared. Wasn't sure it was the best Joker. He looked a little bit deep on the brakes and maybe had to wait for the car to turn in, not to run into the K-rail. Speed just on a slight angle up and over the crest. And Travis now has got to chase down Kevin Hansen. Scott Speed is out front. How far back is Kevin? What's the gap at the minute? It says around 1, and Travis is already onto the back of Kevin.
Yeah, this is an unbelievable move here. Let's see it. Let's see if he can hold that line. Because look at Hansen and Pastrana. They are about a half a second off of each other. So I think that was really smart of Pastrana to get that Joker lap out of the way. But Scott Speed, he still has to hit it. I have to assume he's going to take it on that final lap.
If I were Travis, I might have waited one more lap just to apply a bit of pressure to Scott, you know, just to be in his mirrors. Now he's coming up behind Kevin. If Kevin doesn't go Joker here, our Travis has responded. Sorry, Scott's responded. So Scott Speed goes this for the win. Travis Pastrana coming out. Can't quite get past. There's a lap to go, so they're still going to race to the line. I thought he might just get in front there, and that would have given him the pole position, if you like, for the win, but it's so close between them.
2.5 seconds between Speed and Kevin Hansen, the only threat to not have Subaru with that 1 and 2. This is a huge success for this Subaru team after just a crazy, you know, turn of events. Pastrana, Backerud, and of course, Scott Speed. And look at this. They're wheel to wheel. It's going to come down to this. This is bragging rights.
It's super close between them. Speed's got that inside line. Travis going to stay high this time. Last time they switched it up, I think he's got enough to hold on. Timmy Hansen, Kevin Hansen have gone in the background. McConnell's the only driver who hasn't joked.
Big airing out of Travis Pastrana. Here goes Scott Speed, currently in the lead. Both of them hit the Yokohama Tire Joker lap. It's going to be Subaru 1 and 2. The blue crew is making it to the finish. There's Scott Speed coming across. Travis Pastrana in second. Blue Subaru 1 and 2. Well done with Kevin Hansen coming in third and Timmy Hansen in fourth. A Hansen did not win a Nitro Rallycross round.
And a Subaru did. So that's finally for Subaru. They've been desperate to get the big win in this series. Scott Speed takes his first Nitro Rallycross win. His teammate Travis Pastrana right behind him. It was a fierce rivalry between them. What a great way to end the weekend here at ERX.
Wow, absolutely well done. And everybody said it. The Hansons, you know, they're The Subarus are familiar with this track. They did testing here. The cars are developed. Travis Pastrana gives so much accolades to that of Scott Speed. Rightfully so, he gets the win. I don't know how they made it through turn one without any carnage.
Backer tried to shut the door on Kevin Hansen, but he hadn't quite edged him enough off the line, Jared. If he'd been another half car in front, he could maybe have squeezed Kevin out. Kevin held on, and it was P2 here. The really good move in this was Travis on Kevin. It was a pass on track four position, which was lined up for so much earlier. So this is Pastrana and Kevin on the run up to Timmy Hansen outside. Look, Timmy's up into P3 almost at this point. Backerud is in second place here. So Backerud, wait, so Travis has dropped back to P5 at this point, look. Now watch Andreas Backerud, he hits the wall there.
And then it kicks him over to the
and
burn.
And in fact, so Timmy followed him in, Jared. Yeah. You're blindsided. When you're that close, he's followed Andreas in. They both hit the wall. So this is Kevin, Pastrana on the inside, and they go side by side over the jump. The key to this is Kevin's got the inside line for the next corner, but Travis just holds on until the hairpin.
And Scott kind of held him up, not by design, not malicious, but that's racing, that's strategy.
It wouldn't surprise me, and that's no problem if it did,
no.
Because again, it's within the rules. But to be fair, I mean, look at this. Travis is now going to come around the outside line and holds on for the inside of the hairpin. It really was a great, I'll tell you what, he nearly got Scott.
Look at that, and that's where Travis made the move and just really solidified it, and then he did not look back, taking out Kevin Hansen.
I love these slow-mos. Look at the rotation on Timmy Hansen there in P4, just to see the car moving around underneath them. Fantastic driving on what is a brilliant circuit. Yeah, we hoped that the high line, low line stuff would work. It has. Yeah, this pass was lined up 3-4 corners, half a lap ago. It's been great.
Just overall, a great weekend overall with the next cars, side-by-sides, and of course, supercars, like you said, 6,000 horsepower out there on track. And Scott Speed lives up to his name. He is the fastest out here this weekend at ERX, and I think ERX has proved to just be a phenomenal track. You know, from yesterday, it was really wet, and we never looked back as well, just like Scott Speed.
He was never going to do anything reckless on the last lap. If it had been anyone else, maybe he could have tried something. Look how hard he was trying here. So close to the back of Scott Speed. But Speed, really, really tactical masterclass this weekend. Popular or not, doesn't make any difference. He knew what they needed to do to lock out the front row. It paid off. But for me, the driver of the day is actually Pastrana, dropping to fifth and fighting his way back to P2. Really impressive.
And Sage Karam.
Yes, in NRX Next.
NRX
yeah,
Next.
Yeah, absolutely amazing. If you haven't seen that, go and find it.
Yeah, exactly.
Insane.
Great effort by all the drivers. And, in LCQ, we saw more damage and more carnage in LCQ than we even did the final. But keeping it clean, keeping the cars right. But Subaru 1 and 2, it's crazy.
Look at Pastrana trying. He was desperate to shut the door on Scott, wasn't he? But he was just two car lengths far up the road. It slid the car right out wide. Yes, yeah, Scott, fair go, totally deserved.
Scott Speed wearing his, and there it is, 1 and 2. My man Lewis getting the shot.
They work together.
Part of the Subaru pit.
Brilliant.
All right, well, let's throw it down to Katie Osborne, who's with our winner.
Yeah, there's a whole lot of celebrations happening right now for Scott Speed. First American on top of the box in Nitro Rallycross. Congratulations for that. You said that was awesome. Describe from start to finish.
Oh, yeah, that's an America 1-2. I mean, it helps when you come to a track that's got so many jumps that you have the best guy that jumps in the business. You know, we're a really great team. We both learn a lot from each other, and that's the product. I mean, Subaru gives us great cars. We have an amazing team, and we executed perfect today.
You executed perfect all weekend. The strategy completely paid off. How was the focus for you in that car, knowing that target was on that back?
Well, I know Drax is really fast, so I didn't, he's a tough guy to race here, and we have great cars, so I knew I had to drive a really clean race with no mistakes, and we were able to do that.
As it relates to Subaru Speed, how you like the ring of that?
What?
You got to do a shoey.
Water?
Yeah.
Okay, fill it up with water. I got you.
All right, here we go. Oh, we're doing a shoey?
We're doing a shoey in here, guys.
We're doing
water,
a shoey, baby.
We got a Red Bull.
Water, Red Bull.
Water or Red Bull?
Liquid gas.
Anyone got a Red Bull?
All right, Travis got some alcohol, right, but Scott doesn't
maybe
drink.
Maybe a couple in there.
I like the fact there Travis is like, I've got this. I'm going to get a Red Bull, basically. He's desperate to see Scott drink out of a dirty, sweaty, filthy shoe.
Classic.
We're going to start the party early.
There we go.
Get it in the shoe, Scott.
You guys are going by. The party will be right over there at the Subaru Hauler, going on indefinitely.
Scotty, drink it out of your shoe, buddy.
Now, they're not there yet with the shoe, but this is something you can see the celebrations are happening down here. We're looking for the shoe. We're also looking for Travis Pastrana because we want to talk to him. And if we have any other final words, we were talking about Subaru speed and how this means so much to Subaru getting on the podium after round one.
Dude, it means a lot to me. I mean, the coming back from the broken back is no easy task mentally, physically, and to come to a track like this that has got so many jumps, so many places where I have to trust that the car is going to make it and really fight fears. I mean, every time I look at a jump, I still think a little bit about breaking my back, and I'm really proud of the progress and making that.
I know you guys are doing important stuff, but wait, you want to do it on your shoe? Or you got to take it on my stinky
shoe? Rules, man.
Hey, give me a, hook me up, man. I'm doing, I know it's a second, but I'm doing a shoe anyway, man.
It's a Subaru win regardless. There we go. Travis
kind of like a birthday celebration too, guys. Remember, it's Travis's birthday coming up this next week.
This
and so
what the cool guys do? Cheers, man. Hey.
You
make some noise. There's your one and two. Katie, go ahead and take a hit off that shoe.
Won, but I'm gonna bask in that.
Yeah, you know what? That's their sweat that's on their feet.
It tastes surprisingly good, actually.
And Travis, for you, you basically had one of those moves that was the difference maker in this.
No, it was awesome. And Scott's been so amazing, and Snackaroo's been absolutely awesome. I just can't get through that first lap, man. I got to get my timing better on the starts. But Scott's been trying to get me up to speed. Say what you will about anything, but I tell you what, this man, he is super smart. He's super calculated, and it's awesome to have him on my team and to get Subaru to where I believe we have the best cars on the circuit. First round was rough for all of us, but this is awesome, man. And to go 1-2, you know, I don't like to do shoeys for second. I'm not happy with second. I do want to kick his butt as much as anybody else's, but I definitely appreciate it, Scott.
You know what, Travis, you set that move up on Kevin there nearly perfectly, but it felt like it was kind of a couple of yards back before you made the move. How'd you do it?
I don't know. I went back to like fifth at the beginning, so I was like, oh man, we got to go. And I just felt like we had the quickest car on the track. Finally, this is the first time I had confidence. I had confidence that I could win. I had confidence that I belonged up in the front. We got the best in the world here. And I always jump into other series, and this time everyone's kind of coming to my world. We got some jumps. We got some scary stuff. Super challenging. The Carlsons did such a great job with the track. And just huge thanks to Red Bull, to Yokohama, to Subaru. Everyone that's helping out to make this series, it's only going to get better from here. And the crowd was into it. I tell you what, the Pit Viper, the van race in the middle might have been the highlight. So we're gonna keep adding more excitement, more Nitro Circus stuff. We're going to build this into the festival where we got 100 supercars battling for the lead, and that's going to be even awesome.
Yeah, there's going to be a whole lot of celebrations happening in the Subaru camp. That's been happening all day, in fact, as we know. But, man, the party is going to continue. Kicking it off with a shoey.
Thank you so much, Katie. And congratulations. There is our podium finishers. Scott Speed gets the win with a Subaru 1-2, Travis Pastrana in second, and Kevin Hansen finishes out that final podium spot. Congratulations, Scott Speed, your winner here at ERX round two of Nitro Rallycross. So victory tastes like alcohol or a Red Bull in a shoe in this instance. Have you had a shoey?
I haven't had a shoey. I'm definitely not having a shoey from Scott or Travis. I'll consider one from my own if I win stuff. But, oh, wow, look at the championship.
That.
87 points apiece, Timmy Hansen and Scott Speed.
Timmy Hansen and Scott Speed are tied for the lead. And this, you know, what's interesting, battle brackets on qualifying day make a difference. 1 point is up, 4 points up, right? So there we go. Spray some champagne, boys. There you are, Scott Speed, Travis Pastrana, and Kevin Hansen, your podium finishers here at round two of Nitro Rallycross.
Great to see the crowd down there. Everybody's left the area in front of me and Joe. We've been left completely on our own up here, and they've all gone down to the podium, which is brilliant. Full access down there in the paddock. Everybody's been wandering around. Look at that. Fantastic.
Awesome.
You name another sport you can get so close to that. Wonderful.
As the festivities continue, we'll take a look at this finals in Supercar Finals overall. This is how it all went down. Three wide, going in turn one. Nobody got into each other.
Well, Baccarat tried, didn't he, to shut the door on Kevin Hansen. It didn't quite work out. Travis, at this point, is the third of the Subarus. You can see disappearing off into the dust. So it's whole shot for Scott Speed with Kevin Hansen alongside. Baccarat here is in third, but watch for him hitting the wall. There it is. Timmy Hansen follows him in. Meanwhile, Travis goes on the left line, and that sets him up to get into third behind Kevin. But it was the later laps when he made the pass here, Jared, that was so impressive.
It shows you how critical qualifying is. Getting on that front row, you're not going to get in a tussle, especially if you're teammates. So Scott Speed, Travis Pastrana out front. Kevin Hansen tried to give it a go, but these guys worked well together. That's why they finished out 1 and 2. Elation in the Subaru pits.
An end to the Swedish dominance, a Subaru win, a USA win. Brilliant. So this is the split line. Travis is on the right here, Scott's on the left. They got into racing each other. Once Travis had managed to pass Kevin Hansen, it was about whether or not he could pass his own teammate, Scott Speed. This was the incredible move. He'd set it up from the split lane coming down the backside of the track, around the outside here. Kevin looks like he's going to hold on, but he gets him up at the hairpin. Then the chase between him and Scott Speed. Fantastic.
Really well done. And Travis just says it. He sounds like a broken record. Scott Speed has helped develop the cars, helped them get off the line. He's teaching him, you know, racing line. He's teaching him all these things. Scott Speed has been an absolute teacher for Pastrana, and he gives a lot of credit to why he finished second today. Like you said, Chewy's, you know, Chewy's in second place. Whatever. It's an American win, 1 and 2, and it's a Subaru.